So can somebody come up and do number one for me, please? Marissa. So check your work, please, as she is doing it. And Marissa, can you explain to us what you did?
I converted the 5 and the 4 and 6, 6, and I subtracted 4, 6, 6 minus 3, 5, 6 and 4 minus 3 is 1.
Can you tell me why you did this step right here? Why did you regroup it that way? It makes it easier, right? So you, does everybody understand that 4 and 6, 6 is the same as 5?
Yeah. Yes.
Why?
Because 6.
Jacqueline?
Because she regrouped it.
She regrouped it. But why is, what tells me that it's equal to 5? Yes?
Because it's just like a whole number, but just in a fraction.
So which part of this is a, explain to me, which one equals a whole?
4, 6, 6.
6, 6 is the same as one whole, right? So that's 4 and 1, really. It's a 4 and a 1, which make 5. So that's, she just regrouped it. Very nice. Yes, Jocelyn? Oh, you want to try and go to number 2? Who wants to do number 2? Jose. Did everybody get 1 and 1, 6?
Yep.
Okay. All right, let's see what he did here. Okay, what did you do, Jose?
I put 3 plus 1 to what equals 4. 3 plus 1 which would make 4. And then make the 10 into a 3, into an equal number of 10, which would make 4 and 10, 10. And put the 1 and 3 10 down there, and that will take away.
Okay, so let's see. So you broke down the 4. You regrouped the 4 into a 3 and a 1, right? And then did you rewrite the 1 using a fraction? How would you write the 1 using a fraction? And you would use which denominator? You would use tens, right? So how would you write 1 using tens? Huh? How would you write 1 using tens? What fraction? What fraction gives you 1 using tens?
10 tenths.
So why don't you erase that 1 or cross it out and put 10 tenths there instead of 1? So you got 3 and 10 tenths, right? 3 and 10 tenths, not 4 and 10 tenths. It's 3 and 10 tenths.
Yeah.
Minus 1 and 3 tenths. Two and 7 tenths, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. What was his mistake? Or what was his mistake that he made here? Okay, and we learn from mistakes, so it's okay to make a mistake. Kennedy.
He had a 3 plus 1 and added an extra 1 to make 4 vowels.
He had 4 and 10 tenths, which really is 5, right? And we didn't want a 5, we wanted a 4. So he did the right step. He regrouped it. He did 3 and 1, but he didn't do the fraction part of it. The 10 tenths. He added the 4 and then he added 1 whole. Do you understand, Jose, what you did? Yeah? Alright. So check your other work, Jose. Maybe you did the same thing on the other ones. Check it. Okay, number 3. Saul, can you come do it, please? Okay, explain what you did because you did it pretty quick there. Explain to me what you did. Tell me what you did. Mm-hmm. So you regrouped it into 1 5/5, right? Okay. And you did that in your head, right? You didn't write it down. You skipped that step. You did it in your head. Okay. And you're there. That's where you're at. Yeah. Good. And then you just subtract it. Any questions? No? Good job. Did everybody get 3/5?
Yep. Yeah.
All right. Jelena, can you do number 4, please? Explain to us, please, what you did.
I regrouped the 3 into 2 3/3, and I subtracted it to 2 1/3, and it was equal to 2/3.
2/3, right? Because 2 - 2 is 0, and 3/3 - 1/3 is 2/3. Any questions? All right. Okay. We're going to go on, but can somebody tell me the answer for number 1? What did you get? Jocelyn, what did you get? 7 5/8. Did everybody get 7 5/8?
Yes.
Anybody get something different? No? Okay. Michaela, what do you get for number 2?
1 1/5.
Anybody get something different?
No.
Everybody got 1 1/5. You got something different? No? You want to give me the answer for number 3? All right, Amy. What's the answer for number 3?
3 5/12.
3 5/12. Oh, can't see it. Thank you. Everybody got 3 5/12?
Yes.
Nobody got something different? Hey, it's okay if you got something different. You can let me know. Jose, you got something different?
Yeah.
What did you get?
I got 2 5/12.
2 5/12. So let's look at that problem then. So how would we break up the 9, Jose? How would we regroup the 9? 7 + 2. Is that the best way to regroup it?
Adding 7 and 12, 12.
7 and 12, 12. What does that equal? Let's look at that, Jose. 7 and 12, 12. That's a 7, and what's this?
One whole.
That's a 1 whole, right? What does that make? What number does that make? 7 and 1?
8.
It makes an 8. What's the number here?
9. 8.
So 9. We need a 9. So let's regroup it, Jose. Do it with me. How would we group the 9? What would we break it down to?
7 + 2?
We want a 1.
8.
Huh? We want a 1. We want something plus 1. That gives us 9.
8.
8. We want 8. 8 plus 1, right? And how can we rewrite the 1 using 12s?
Eight.
Huh?
8 and 12, 12.
8 and 12, 12. So now we have 8 and 12, 12 minus 5 and 7, 12. Can we do this problem now, Jose? Yeah? So 8 minus 5 is?
3.
3 and 12, 12 minus 7, 12. 5 12. So, who gave me that answer, Amy? You're the one who gave it, right? Do you see, Jose? Okay. Let's try the next one. Miguel. 4/7. Did anybody get something different? Jose, what did you get on that one?
I didn't
finish. Oh, you didn't finish? Okay. Go ahead and do it, and then let me know what you got. You have a comment, Jeffrey.
Except he'd have to have 24
12. That's a really good solution. Let's see if that works. So Jeffrey says he could have broken down the 7 and 2, but what's another way of doing a 2 using 12?
24 12.
Why 24 12?
12 times 2 is 24.
Because 24 divided by 12 is 2, right? And we know that a fraction is basically a division problem. Okay, so 24, so that would be 1. And so if he regrouped it, 7 and 24 12 minus 5 and 7 twelfths, what would he get? He would get a 2. And then 24 minus 7 would be what? 24 minus 7 would be 17 twelfths. What fraction? What kind of fraction is this?
Improper.
It's an improper fraction, so that means we need to make it into a mixed number. 17 twelfths is equal to what? 1 and 5 twelfths. How do we know that? Angela? Twelve goes into 17 one time, and you have 5 left, so it's 5 twelfths, right? So 1 and 5 twelfths. So now we have 1 and 5 twelfths and 2. What does that give us?
3 and 5
twelfths. So it gives us the same answer. It takes the same place, but it's just a little bit more work, right? So we're trying to simplify it as easy as we can do it, but we would get there. We would get there. All right. Any questions on these? No? Okay, let's put this paper away for a little bit. We'll come back to it in a little while.